three bills signed into law designed to trim taxes for the middle class. Are they enough to help? Answers just ahead on KETV News Watch 7 at 6. Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Melissa Frank for Brandi Peterson. Governor Dave Heineman says the three tax cutting measures are small but important steps to changing the state's tax climate. But he makes it clear he wants more.
In tonight's big story, our Andrew Ozaki says the governor continues his call for a more modern and fair tax system, one that would significantly reduce or eliminate state income taxes. And he vows to keep the pressure on lawmakers.
Thank you very much.
With a stroke of a pen, Nebraska families will soon get higher tax deductions on college savings plans. We'll no longer have to pay a state alternative minimum tax and get tax breaks on employee-owned stocks for retirement.
They were small steps forward. I appreciate it, but we could have done a lot more.
The governor, clearly disappointed he wasn't signing into law the bold tax reform he introduced at the beginning of the session. It called for eliminating or significantly reducing the state's individual income tax.
You've heard me say it before. The fastest growing states economically are those without an income tax or very low rates.
Lawmakers tabled the governor's plan, opting instead to form this 15-member committee, which had its first meeting on Monday. It will study and come up with a tax reform package for next year.
We're going to work hard to come up with something that will try and make our tax system more equitable.
But many senators say they are not willing to remove the sales tax exemptions the governor's plan called for on farm equipment, hospital room stays, prescription drugs, and manufacturing materials.
I think we got a pretty sound feedback that that is not something that people want.
Some senators also believe reducing property taxes should be a big part of the discussion.
The only way you can get to that from a state perspective is to give local governments additional funding and then lower the amount that they're allowed to raise in property taxes.
Well, I'm very concerned about the direction that I hear certain members of the legislature discussing.
The governor says reform should be about lower taxes and more job creation, but getting what he wants might be a challenge. Next year is an election year, and his last year as governor, in a session that only lasts 60 days.
But I'm going to keep the pressure on.
In Lincoln, Andrew Ozaki, KETV, News Watch 7.
Now, that special legislative tax committee met for a little over an hour this afternoon. They discussed expectations and they outlined a process. Their next meeting is scheduled for July 10th.